On Monday, I was picked up from school. On Tuesday morning, I was in the hospital in Long Island. By Wednesday, I was back in Iowa. By Thursday night, I had my transplant, and I woke up on Friday morning with a new liver. You can be living your life a normal person, and then the next day start feeling like you have a cold, and then the next week you end up in the hospital and you need an organ donation.
Emily's case was very unique in that she was so ill. Most of the folks that we transplant have chronic liver disease, and so their disease takes place over months and years, and we have a much wider timetable to get them transplanted. In Emily's case, she was very ill at the time of her presentation. She had a disease that was attacking her liver and making her very sick at the over a period of days to weeks. Our timeline is much shorter in those cases. Fortunately, they don't happen very often, probably a couple of cases a year. However, it does shorten our timeline to be able to save the patient's life. And in Emily's case, she headed downhill very quickly.
The reality is that when the liver fails, every other organ fails as well. It's called multi-organ failure.
There is a special allocation procedure for patients with acute liver failure, and it does put them up at the top of the list very quickly. But in her case, we had a matter of hours to get a liver transplant before she was going to succumb to her disease.
In most transplant stories, it's always someone's joy and someone's happiness. But it also has to do with someone's losing a family member. And for me, because I was so close in age to my donor, she was also a young student who was traveling home to see her family for Thanksgiving. It's hard to not be impacted by that. Though my family was able to keep their beloved daughter, someone had to lose theirs. And I think that you have a more sense to do something good with your life, and that you want to carry on so that that family knows that their daughter or their son or whomever helped another person live a fulfilling life.
Emily's case is special outside of the fact that she was transplanted, in that we did get to develop a relationship with her and her family. We've kept in touch over the years since she's been transplanted, and it's a special gift to us to be able to see the things that she's been able to accomplish. Being in college at the time of her transplant, we did celebrate her graduating from college and got to see her go on to finish grad school and to pursue a career in healthcare, and her desire to go on and help other people that had similar healthcare issues.
People back on the East Coast are surprised when I say that I chose to come back to Iowa instead of going to someplace else in Manhattan or a bigger hospital system. But people in Iowa are not surprised, because it's a source of pride for Iowans, the University of Iowa hospitals and clinics. I think that it's an amazing place, and I don't think that there's anyone who's used this system that doesn't know that.
Organ transplants at University of Iowa hospitals and clinics have transformed lives since 1969. Within the next few weeks, university will perform its 5,000th organ transplant. That's more than any other medical center in Iowa. Please welcome Emily Berg.
I find that if you make it personal and you say, look at what I've done since my transplant, or you say, this is how many people one person can save. There's so many different ways that just checking a box on your driver's license can really help tons and tons of people.
We're coming up to 5,000 solid organ transplants. This is an amazing situation. I've been in this business now with this organ center almost 2 decades now. Those transplants that we've done over the years, I've seen them going from people who are incredibly sick, literally at death's door, getting the transplant, waking up, getting back to health, and then following them through over the years to the most amazingly great health, going back to their full life. It is a miracle, to be honest. It is such a privilege and such a gift to be able to be part of that. And a lot of the patients that we see as well, they say, oh, it's such a gift. I've been given such a new lease on life. I'm just making the most of it. The patients that I see on a week-to-week basis, day-to-day basis, they just make a huge difference in my life, just being able to continue to do this and have this tremendous fulfillment at being part of a team that is able to effect these kind of miracles and this kind of change in people's lives.